What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today we're going to review Amberscript. This one turns your audio and videos into text. This is really useful when you want to later on add subtitles to a video, or maybe you heard a podcast or a movie and you want to grab the text from the audio in those files. So that's possible with Amberscript. In this video, I will be covering what I like and dislike about it and what is missing on Amberscript. So let's go jump over to the deal that's going on right now and then later on jump into the dashboard of Amberscript to show you how it actually works. So let's go jump over there right now. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $69 for a lifetime deal. And let me show you what that gets you really quickly. The first plan, that's $69, gets you 2 hours of uploaded audio or videos per month. So that means each month it starts resetting for 2 hours on this plan. Now, if you guys want to grab the deal that's going on right now, do consider using that link in the description if you find this video helpful and want to help me out with a small commission. Now, if 2 hours is not enough, I recommend jumping to license tier 2, which gives you more hours, and you can go all the way up to tier 5 with 50 hours. So depending how much transcribe time you need, it's a license that you're going to need. Now, there's no extra perks for jumping into license tier 2, 3, or 4. I mean, there's no extra accounts, no extra team members or anything like that. It's just more hours. So maybe you're good with 2 hours. Well, that's just fine. Okay, let's go jump over to my files. So basically, there's two files I uploaded already. It's this one that I tested from a video I just made previously, and I just uploaded a brand new one. So let me show you what that looks like right now. So I just uploaded the video, and these are the options that I get. Now, it's really important that you check out what's going on right here, because this will help you on your buying decision. Because first of all, you're going to see the languages that are available for transcribing. Do check if the language that you need is here. And I guess there's a list available, but I will leave that in the description. Because, I mean, if the language that you are uploading or the videos that you need transcription is not available, well, this deal's not for you. So in this case, this video that I uploaded, it's in English, and they have two types of English. So all accents and Australian. So I guess they speak really differently than they do in English, but I'm guessing they should also add from UK, the United Kingdom, because I think that English is a bit different from the United States English, all right? So just consider that. So all accents there. How many speakers are on this video? In this case, I'm the only one speaking, so one, okay? And then we have two options. Is it transcription that I need, or is it subtitles? In my case, what I want is subtitles because it'll give me the time code, okay? If not, it's just written text for a document, use transcription. Now I'm using automatic. That is the balance that I have from the lifetime deal that I purchased. And there's also manual, which gives you, you have to pay for this, all right? So that's not included. So in this case, we're good to go. Let's order this. And it'll start the process. Once it's finished, we're going to get an email from the transcription that it's done. So you see, your transcription is in the queue and will begin shortly. So we gotta wait for that one to get finished, right? But I already have one uploaded, and one of the things that changes, I'll show you in a bit. So for example, here's the file that I already uploaded. Let me open this. And I already asked for the transcription. Now, I see something really weird going on Amberscript. First of all, it's that I already did a transcribe here, so that's why it gave me time code. And now that I have the time code, I can edit based on time code. But if I didn't do the transcribe, I just have the whole text all together. And I'll show you that once this is done. Once that's done, I'll show you what that actually looks like. But once I transcribed, this is what I get. Now, I haven't added anything right here. This is just what I got. And one of the things I do really dislike about Amberscript is that I don't have a personalized vocabulary, okay? Why is that important? First of all, let's start with this right here. It says, "What's up, SaaS Masters?" You know, I always start like that. And it says subsidizers, all right? So that's what it understood. But if I had a vocabulary saying that, hey, this is something that I use commonly, SaaS Masters, then if you kind of hear that, then put it here. So there's no vocabulary there. Now, it's also really important when we're talking about brands, okay? So for example, let's just say in this case right here, I'm talking about Amberscript, okay? The most likely thing that it's going to do when it transcribes it is going to say probably Amber, like the stone from Amber. That's precious stone. and it's gonna say script. So it's gonna divide it instead of saying, hey, you know what? It's one single word. Now, if I had a special vocabulary, I would tell it, hey, you know what? Amberscript is a brand and it's spelled together. So if you hear that, put it together. Okay, so I don't have that. That's really important that I think a transcription software should have. Why? Because it saves you time. Instead of doing this manually, so now I'll have to edit this, SaaS Masters. Okay, that's how it sounds. Then I would have to do it manually and I'll have to check everything right here. And there's also a misspelling here, Taste WPE. I'm talking about Taste WP. Again, we're talking about a brand, should be together. Now, if I click play right here.
What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I'm gonna show you a completely free tool that's called Taste WP. This one is great for—
I do like that it's following with an underline how the audio with the text is showing. That's really good. A thing that also I think is missing that's really important is that I think that Amberscript should let me know when a word is kind of not right. So for example, right here we saw, remember, SaaS Master? If it didn't hear right and it thinks it's wrong, it should kind of highlight it. Say, hey, you know what? This could potentially be wrong. Go ahead and check it. So it saves me time to look at it. In this case, I'll have to go through all the text, make sure that everything is right, and then I'll grab the transcription. Okay, things that you have to know. Let's go check out if this is done. No, it's not done yet. Let's refresh. No, not done. So let's keep showing right here. So first of all, we have the audio right here. We have the speed that we can change. If we want to hear it faster because we want to save time, that's possible. We can go back 5 seconds, hit play, forward 5 seconds. Really cool thing that they have is that shortcuts are available, and this is what you can do. For example, if I hit Command Z, it'll undo, Command plus C, it'll redo, and you have all these options available to obviously get around there, okay? We also have the export option. In this case, I already transcribed. So if I wanted subtitles, I have the SRT file, the VTT, or the EBU. Most common one used is SRT, okay? That's the most common one used. And if I needed the video download with the included subtitles, that's available. But if I just need this, I'll export subtitles and I'll grab them. Okay, a nice thing that I like about Amberscript is that we can edit these. For example, if I'll delete the whole thing, we are still working with the timeline, okay? This hasn't been changed. I can modify it, but it won't get modified if I remove a word. Some transcription softwares, if I remove a word, it'll move the whole transcription and it'll mess up everything. Why is that something that could bother you? In my case, if I use a transcription to upload on YouTube, well, the video's already working there. I haven't cut the video. I mean, I'm just removing the word here or adding a word. I don't want the timing to change. So this is something that Amberscript does have. So that's pretty good. Let's go wait for this one to finish. All right, it's done. Let me open it up. Now, one of the things I do dislike about Amberscript is that this is how you get the transcription to get started, all right? Unless I create the subtitles. And if I create the subtitles, it's not immediate. It also does a transcription work. And this video took around like 20 minutes, right? So it's not super fast. Not something I'm worried about because I don't care about if it takes 20 minutes or 1 hour. I mean, it's just when it's done, I'll start working on it. But yes, it doesn't do it from the beginning. So if I wanted the timing, I'll have to create subtitles first. And again, I haven't edited this, but this is how you get the whole thing. I think it's kind of clunky editing this way, or it could be faster for you. If you think this is better, I mean, it could be, right? You'll just see everything right here really quickly, start editing, find mistakes that you might find, edit, and then go create the subtitles and give it that final tweak if you want. But like I said before, this might be the best way to edit for most people, okay? And again, we have the timeline, the start time, the length, the speed, if you want to do that, the playhead, and all of the good stuff. Basically, that is what Amberscript does. I mean, it's pretty simple right now. What it does is, I mean, you just transcribe and it creates a text, go edit it and export. They will be adding more features. Here's the roadmap. Again, the roadmap, it's not big right now. I'm guessing since they just launched this lifetime deal, they want our feedback to consider it. But if not, if this is what's going on, it's kind of simple as it is right now, and it's not gonna get much better because that's all they're looking for right now. So let's find out and see if they're gonna take our suggestions into consideration. But for now, something that I find interesting is the, where is it? the Zapier integration. So what I'm thinking is that when a video is uploaded or something happens in somewhere, it's gonna grab that text and it's gonna transcribe it for us. Well, not actually the text, it's gonna grab the audio or video and it's gonna transcribe it for us. So I think that one is interesting. Two-factor authentications, not that biggie. Subtitle timeline editing, I think that's what they mean by editing the in the beginning, convert it into subtitles instead of waiting for it to get subtitled and then editing. That could be it, or editing the timing on it. So, but what I look at for, what I'm looking right now, is that it's already editable right here, the timing. Is it? Let's see, this one, 009. So if I change it to, for example, 10, adjust. Yeah, it does adjust. So the timing is adjustable. I mean, they might be looking at, for example, moving these blocks or something like that. Not something I would think that would work, because it's text that has to go in certain timing. But let's see what they are planning to do. But basically, that is it. Other things we can do is change the language on the portal, like how we're working with. English, Dutch, German, French, Spanish, Italian, and Portuguese. If I change to Spanish, well, it does change it. For example, velocidad, exportar, creado. Yeah, it is in Spanish. So we can change that portal title. But basically, that is Amberscript. Do consider what you think about the deal. If $69 is worth it for 2 hours of transcription time, then it's a good deal. I think they should raise the hour amount for the price that they're offering, unless they add more features that make it really interesting, then we're good to go with that price. But let me know what you guys think in the comments about this deal, if it's good or not, or what alternative are you using right now. Well guys, I thank you all for watching. My name's George, this is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.